What's going on? No, this is not a vlog. This is, you know, yeah. And it's not a mukbang. 6:49, eating my dinner on a, what's today? Tuesday afternoon, it is 6:49. I was just here responding to comments on a post that I made on Facebook earlier. I'm gonna read it to y'all and go into what I'm going to talk about real quick. So my post said, so I have a dentist appointment and a receptionist says, how can I help you, sir? The station is chest height, so you can only see from my shoulders up. I told her to always ask a patient's name before addressing them as him or her. Silence. She couldn't even look at me. I want to address this because I've also said things here and there in my vlogs, and some people, I can see, I'm going to take this assumption. They don't have LGBT people in their family, or maybe LGBT friends. Maybe I'm the only gay person, you know. So, it, you know, and I don't blame, I mean, I can't separate blame. It is what it is. You know, like if it's not, and this goes to anything, if it's not in your home or right there beside you, we don't take the time to learn and know things. And I'm putting this to me, to other things. I'm not just saying you gay people. No, it is what it is. So why did that irk me? I wasn't annoyed. It was disrespectful because having a good morning and it's just business. It's just etiquette. If someone comes to you, all you got to say is, how can I help you? You don't have to say him, her, sir, how can I help you? And then as the person speaks, whether it's by, you can't even gauge a person's voice because I answer the phone. People think I'm a dude. How am I supposed to sound? Hello, how you doing? People, stop the fuckery. Stop the fuckery. Women don't sound a certain way. Women don't look a certain way. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. It used to happen to me a lot more often when I was a little bit younger, but it's slowed down. And usually when it's happened before, I didn't really so much correct the person, but I was like, nah, nah, nah. As someone said on my, one of the comments, a teachable moment. Yeah, don't do that shit. Don't do that. Because I do get offended when I'm called a dude. But it's more so, I think I was on it earlier, but now it's more so annoyed. Like, yo, you don't even know my name. You know, like, don't do that. Don't do that. Now, had the thing been lower, should have seen my titties. But my whole thing again is, how can I help you? Or how can I help you? What's your name? It's, first of all, this is an appointment. Oh, how can I help you? What time is your appointment? Then when I say my name is Samantha, then you can say Miss or whatever the hell you want to say. But don't off the back. And I'm like, dude, like, really? What constitutes me for being a dude? Because I'm looking at myself in the view because I'm trying to, if I saw me, I know I'm just that's a masculine woman. I don't know. I'm like, you can put out in the comments. I want to know what about me says dude, because my hair is cut on the sides. This is not, you know, and I hate when people say this is a man's haircut. Who the fuck made this a man's haircut? All this society bullshit, people, stop the fuckery. Stop the fuckery. There's no such thing as a man's haircut. If you want to cut your hair anyway, cut your blinking hair how you want it. Now, to take these things and associate it with a man, that's your business. That's your business. Don't put that shit on anybody else. Don't do that. People look at the outer appearance of masculine women, and they automatically have these thoughts. And it's like, nigga, did I tell you any of this shit? This all on your assumptions. Just because of how I look? How I'm dressed up, and I always say, damn, it don't take much to be a man. If all I gotta do is, do a man cut and put on, it don't take much to be a man. Like, what the fuck? What the fuck? Now, these youngins nowadays, they may like that, oh, bruv, son, oh, my, no, I'm a girl. I'm a girl. And I have nothing against people that you want to be called, you know, you find sir, young ma'am, young mister, no. I'm a girl, okay? I made another on a video on a, I think was it the last vlog or the previous before, when I went shopping and I needed assistance. And this is not the first time I've seen it. And when I said it, other people that are watching that are of masculine center can understand what I'm saying. I can go and ask somebody, you know, a male, and because it's usually male clerks that's around, you know, in these stores. Help for something or what have you. And then they, when they, you know, they can have their back turned to you, say, and they turn to you and it's like, what the fuck? Your job is to tell me where the fuck something is, stock shit, and answer my question. Who gives a fuck what I look like? And then I see the same person, a woman that could come up feminine, ba-da, titties up, ba-da-da. It's a different reaction. No, that's not, we not here. This is not date. This is not dating time. This is, nigga, what the hell, help me with what the hell I need, but treat me like you treat everybody else. It's a fucked up feeling, because it's like, damn, if I look like so-and-so, you would, I deal with people how people talk to me. Just because I look this way, don't talk to me like a nigga, like a dude. Excuse me, black folk, you know, y'all understand. Yeah, don't do it. I've come up against people, when you just green them, they don't know, should they shake your hand and give you a pound? Nigga, what is your fucking problem? This world we live in is so fucked up. For those of you raising young kids, it's a different generation now. My generation and older, yo, the fuckery, man, the fuckery. Teach your children, teach your friends, even now, there is not a woman doesn't look one way. Teach your kids. You know, I don't, you know, I kind of laugh at kids, and then when they stare, I be like, I straight up say it. It's not polite to stare. I straight up do it. Because if you as a parent ain't going to teach your child right, I'm going to do it for you. And I wish someone would say something to me. Oh, please, Jesus, say it. I wish. Because they know that, what your kid's staring at me for? Trying to see if I'm a girl or a boy? Teach your kid from home. It ain't hard. It's not hard. Stop putting these, your fucked up norms on who you think someone should be, or how they should look, or how they should behave. No, take people for who they say they are. Okay? If I said, you know, I correct people in these comments sometimes, or mostly on my review channel. All these male terminologies, I be saying it's ma'am or it's sis. And like, oh, I call it, no, it's ma'am or it's sis. Hey, if I can set this precedent for just, I'm gonna do it. Stop it. Stop it. I see women look harder than me. Heterosexual. Spitting out the babies. What the fuck does how I look like determine if I'm a man or a woman? Stop your fuckery, people. So when I say different things, try to understand. You got to do your own research to understand the LGBTQIA da-da-da-da-da-da community and things we go through. But me as a masculine-centered woman, I experience different things than a feminine lesbian woman does. You know, it's totally different. I was talking to someone the other day, and we was talking about an instance of PDA. And she was explaining how someone she used to date, she's bisexual, and someone she used to date is masculine-centered and had a problem with public displays of affection. Now, I could understand both sides. She said, you know, wow, me as a bisexual woman, I'm more comfortable, you know, with PDA than she is. But you got to understand, you're feminine-looking. So when that man looks at you, that man looks at you and then looks at who your partner is, boy, fire. It's like, why you with that? You know, why you with that? You could be with a real man, but you with, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. So back to that story, I could understand the masculine side, because I've been through situations like that where I've been with women walking in this PDA, and I'll be like, I shy away from it because I have to be mindful of where the fuck I am, because men have a problem with women that look like me. Why? I don't know. I don't want to be you. I don't want to be you. I'm so happy being a woman. Like, what the fuck is wrong with y'all? And when I say, okay, I'm not saying all men, but I know the majority of y'all have thought it somewhere in your mind, and stop the fuckery. Stop. Respect people for who they are, who they tell you they are. Okie dokie. The same way you want someone to treat you with respect, do the same thing for other people. If I wanted to be called him, shim, whatever, call me him, shim, or whatever. But I'm not saying that. Call me Samantha, her, she, with all other women stuff. Woman, girl, what, everything related to a female, that's what I am. And I love it.